This is a paranormal short session two. I turned it off by mistake. Paranormal short session two by Keith Evans. I'm at the gravesite of the Buck family in Apalachicola. And today is Monday, 6th of June, 2022. This is Therese McBride Buck. She was born July 28th, 1892, and she passed away November 2nd, 1972. So there's only three tombstones of Buck family members, and there looks like there's room enough for at least, I would say, at least four on this side and one here. So I don't know if there's burials without any tombstone or what, but I'm gonna go over to I wrote to Hayes House about Jeff Buck, about the house he built in 1908. His legal name is James Fulton Buck. And I'm going to go ahead and turn on the Envoy. The Envoy is a new piece of equipment, Jeff. I hope you don't mind me calling you Jeff. Well, I can call you Mr. Buck, unless you want to correct me on that. So, Mr. Buck, the Envoy is hard for some ghosts and spirits to figure out how to use. It has that undulating... where you choose a letter, and it starts at A and goes all the way through Z. I got it at the slowest speed going, but if you're too soon and you choose the letter prior or the letter behind the letter you intended to choose, it's going to throw your word off, and it's going to make it harder to understand. So today, I'm going to start you out with touch. Touch is the way you will choose a letter on the Envoy by Ghost Stop. And the Envoy is just considered to be a ghost box. I'm going to turn it right up to about 11. Face of a clock, it would be 11 and 5. So let's see what word you have chosen, or what letter. I'm going to have to bring it up to my eyeball, because you... it's me, Jeff Buck, Mr. Buck. My first question for Mr. Buck is, did you like my book, The Hayes House Ghost or People 2? Well, this isn't yes or no, but we'll get to that later. If it's yes, could you just choose a Y? If it's no, could you just choose an N? It's a hot day today, no doubt about that. We don't have any shade. I'm going to turn it up a little bit more and see, maybe to 12 noon. If it was position of a clock, it's about at where 12 noon would be and 6 o'clock. And the only button that for sensitivity that is on or turned up to any degree is for the tapping. Now, I'm not quite sure how a ghost or spirit taps. I guess they use their energy quickly to touch the front, or at least this part. You see, I'm doing it. Nothing's happening. No letters being chosen. So I guess, Mr. Buck, if as long as you use your electromagnetic energy and come in and come back out really quick, I guess that's your way of tapping. And I'm not sure which part of this piece of equipment you're going to tap at, but I was told in this area here, so if you could give it a try. If you're not here, maybe one of your other family members would like to try. It seems like I get your youngest daughter a lot. Emmeline. So, Emmeline, if you're here, would you give that a try? My question is, did you like the book, The Hayes House Ghosts or People Too? Well, there's little nuts on the ground, so there's a, be a hickory tree up here someplace. You see the nuts laying on the ground. I mean, if I was a ghost or spirit, I probably wouldn't spend any time hanging out at the place where I was buried. I'd probably go to the places that I liked and loved, like, you know, the Hayes House or other places, maybe Dog Island, if that's where Jeff Buck, James Fulton Buck, went hunting or swimming or wherever he went on vacation to. So, you know, I'm not particularly surprised that I'm not getting much in the way of words or letters. I got you. So, let's move over and see. LG Buck. Same question to you. Did you like the book, The Hayes House Ghosts or People Too? I hate to turn it up too far because it seems like then I just get random, a bunch of random nonsensical letters that don't add up to any words. I'll turn it up a little bit more since LG Buck might be low on energy today. I'll turn it up to about 1 o'clock and 7 on the face of a clock. I'm getting some letters here. I get D, E, F, G. All right, you know your alphabet. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. D, E, F, G. Then U, V. What exactly does U, V stand for? UVC. Oh, that might have been Buck. UVC. That might have been Buck. CK would be Buck. UC. UCK. They might have been trying to spell Buck. But that's still a reach. It's very subjective. It's not an indication of any intelligent ghost or spirit, even though there might be one and they might be doing their best, and it might be very hard to utilize this piece of equipment. But Buck would be B-U-C-K, and we have a U and a V and a C-K, R-N and a Q, P and a Q. X, Y. Now we're just getting a lot of constants from the third row of this alphabet as it's lined up. I think P is from the second row. I got P a couple times, but I don't see any letters there. I got Nope, N-O-P, Q-R-S. All right. Let's go over and see if Teres, I'm trying to think. Weren't you also at one time a elementary school teacher? Would you take over control of the envoy and stop the constant choices of consonants that don't come up to making any words? T-U-Z-A-B-D-E-H-K-L-M. Well, Therese, if you're available today, you're probably someplace where you enjoyed being more so than at your grave. But if you can take control of it and choose some words, this is Mrs. Buck, Therese McBride Buck. Doing my best to see through the lens of the camera. I'm going to have to pick up and go. Just a bunch of constants. There's a couple E's. D. D-E-E. No, D-E-K. Well, Mrs. Buck, if you can come up with any type of words as far as what'd you think about the book, The Hayes House Ghost or People 2? This counts as from the end of the alphabet. Looks like it might have been WXYZ. DEFGE. No, DEFGH. All right, I'm going to go ahead and cut back on the, go back to 12 and 6, where I'm at now as far as the tapping. And I'm going to put her up to yes and no. And I'm going to go back over to Jeff Buck. Jeff Buck, did you like the book, The Hayes House, Ghost or People 2? Am I getting anything? Nothing. Well, I'm going to keep it at 12 since it seems like turning sensitivity up too much and I might be picking up the electromagnetic energy given off by the Earth if we're at a fault line that is a minor fault line. It won't cause an earthquake, but it might cause enough electromagnetic energy that it's going to pick up with the envoy. And also, there's a river in that direction, so that river, you know, might have enough water that might cause the envoy to, enough electromagnetic energy to choose words from the envoy. All right, Mr. LG Buck, would you like to choose yes or no concerning, did you like the book, The Hayes House, Ghost or People 2? Are you upset because I didn't call it the Buck House or the Buck and Hayes House? I mainly had information on the Hayes family and just a little information on the Buck family. And that was one of the reasons why I called it The Hayes House. Even though I know the Buck family was the first family to live there, and they built the house in 1908. Not getting any choice. Not a yes, not a yo. All right, let's go over here to Mrs. Therese McBride book. Would you like to choose a yes or no as to whether you like the book, The Hayes House, Ghosts or People 2? Well, I'd like to apologize to the Buck family for being insensitive towards failing to add their name onto the book. There is one chapter dedicated to the Buck family, but maybe I did wrong. Maybe I should have had it the Buck and the Hayes House. So anyway, we live and we learn. Can I get a yes or a no? Reason why I have it at, you know, the little dial for tapping at 12 and 6 is because at 1 and 7, there seems to be something intrinsically from the earth that's picking up some type of tapping, electromagnetic tapping, and it's just causing it to constantly choose random letters that aren't any type of intelligent, meaningful words. No sentences, no words. So that's why I turned it back to the position, if it was a clock, 12 and 6. That way you can see that there's just no paranormal activity at this point in time. So, all right, we tried, and I guess I should have brought a new, older piece of equipment that the Buck family was familiar with. And if Jeff Buck's youngest daughter, Emmeline, is here, I more than welcome her, to answer the question as far as did Emmeline Buck, or whatever her married name maybe, did she like the book, The Hayes House, Ghosts or People 2? I'll give you a little while to answer, since you might have not thought I was going to include you in. All right. Go back over to Jeff Buck's grave, and we'll end there. This has been Paranormal Short Session 1 by Keith Evans at the Buck family grave here in Apalachicola, Florida. Today is Monday, the 6th of June, 2022. I'm asking you to like, leave comments, and subscribe, and I appreciate all your help. Thank you for watching my YouTube channel. Have a good day.